How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be talking about the security features of Surfshark. So before we begin, if at any point you'd like to check for links or discounts, you'll find the links in the description down below, as well as a full review that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So of course, if we're talking about security, we have to start by mentioning that Surfshark definitely is using the top grade AES-256 encryption with an RSA 2048-bit handshake key. And now with regards to protocols, you may know that we have a handful of protocols here with Surfshark. So IKEV2, OpenVPN, both UDP and TCP, ShadowSox, and WireGuard. Now, you can definitely use the automatic, but I don't like using automatic because, you know, one day it might use WireGuard, another day it might use IKEV2. So for the sake of consistency, I like to use just one protocol, and that'll be the WireGuard protocol 99.99% of the time. You're going to be using WireGuard protocol without any trouble. Of course, you can use IKEV2 if you would like, but this is completely replaced by WireGuard again. IKEV2 is still quick though. OpenVPN, TCP, and UDP are the most secure protocols as far as we know. They're the most audited protocols. So if you're going for security, you can definitely go ahead and use these. OpenVPN having a very good encryption. And if you'd like to kind of even almost double that encryption, you can use the TCP, but of course your speed will be sacrificed here for sure by about 50%, if not more. The ShadowSox protocol will allow you to reach banned websites if you're in a country where there are a bunch of banned websites such as Turkey, UAE, and China. ShadowSox will help you bypass such restrictions so that you can reach such websites. And of course, that would be it for protocols. Again, WireGuard protocol would just be the best option. You can even combine the WireGuard protocol with no borders mode. And by the way, with ShadowSox, you're only securing your browser traffic. So keep that in mind. So I would definitely recommend using WireGuard protocol with no borders mode if you would like to bypass a censorship firewall such as the Great Firewall of China. Another thing is you do have the kill switch, split tunneling, and clean web. So, you know, you've got a good selection of protocol of security features, excuse me. So if you didn't know, the kill switch will terminate your internet connection if your VPN happens to lose its own connection. So that will help you kind of not leak any information out to your ISP so that they don't know what you're doing on the internet, especially if you're in a restrictive country. That will be of great help. And whitelister is pretty much split tunneling, which will give you the ability to choose which applications you would like, or, you know, websites or IP addresses for that matter. And you can choose exactly which websites or applications you would like the VPN to use or bypass, which can be very helpful. So of course, what you could do with whitelister or split tunneling is, for example, only have your torrenting client to be affected by your VPN while leaving the rest of your network untouched. So it could be useful in more than one way. Another thing is you do have an ad blocker, which will block ads, trackers, and malware. And this will especially prove to be useful ad blocking, for example. You could combine that with uBlocker or the ad blocker that you would use on your browser. As far as malware and trackers, it does do a good job. Of course, you know, it's not going to be as good as a dedicated antivirus software, but it does do the job. And of course, lastly, we have static IP and multi-hop. Multi-hop will route your connection through two servers and IP addresses rather than one for extra security. So this can be very useful for those of you that just want to double up on security. Of course, you've got DNS and WebRTC leak blocking. So for more information on that, you'll find what you need in the description down below in the review, where we show the results of a DNS leak. Of course, there's never been any leak, so you don't have to worry about that. In addition to perfect forward secrecy, which is also implemented in Surfshark, which means that a piece of an encryption system automatically and frequently changes the keys it uses to encrypt and decrypt information. such that if the latest key is compromised, it exposes only a small portion of the user's sensitive data, which is very, very useful. So with regards to, of course, security, this is as good as it gets, really. Surfshark is quite a bit secure. And finally, if I didn't mention, of course, a dedicated IP doesn't have to do much with security rather than utility. So if this is something you need, for example, if you need to go back to the same IP address over and over again, the static IP servers can be very helpful, especially when banking, for example. So that'll be it for this video. If you guys are interested in learning more about Surfshark, you'll find a review with full details and more of an in-depth look into the advantages and disadvantages of Surfshark. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. If you learned something in this video, please like the video. It helps us out a lot. And if you'd like to stay up to date with all things cybersecurity and VPNs, be sure to subscribe. Again, you'll find the links to special deals and discounts in the description down below. So feel free to take advantage of those while they last. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.